Then back, it's going to be a little awkward, early engagement. There is the heal, of course, to come across from Swirl if he does choose to throw out that Overgrowth. But now Disco, he's going to hop out almost, and I think this is going to be a real tough one. RDW has been spotted, the Guiding Lights come in, but there we go, Autumn. We know he's good at these frags, but Swirl, he's picked up two. Disco will get the trade, and it's back to a 3-on-2 here.
Yeah, but that's sharp shots come through from Tux. The trade on out Noz now in the 1v2. The Spike in possession, at least able to get this one down, but he's going to stick it in amongst the fault line, which means he's a little bit disoriented at the moment. No stars to speak of either, Mitch. Does mean that he's going to be all on toward this pistol. He's now been seen in amongst the tube as well. This disconnected duel has to work wonders for Noz. The peek on down from Disco, the jump attempt, 3 HP, can he get it done? He needs some right clicks, but no, it's gonna be Disco to close it and get the DQs. The big lean for Order over to the other side of the map, however, makes things more interesting for Wildcard to be able to gain this one a little bit easier.
And it's nice and sort of slow, working it smart. Guiding Light into Hookah, we'll be able to gather that information. Swell sort of sitting onto the other side. RDW! Oh, this is beautiful! Loves to see it. Swell's going to be able to pick up one as well. But again, it's just the bonus. So still some read. You know how good Autumn can actually be. We'll be looking up towards the top. But Swell does actually manage to find Disco in the process as well. The dash on the way back as well is going to be able to utilize the Overgrowth to get the heal back in. It's going to be Texter, the guy that has to be Mr. Impact with this position beyond. But with that Viper spin down, it's going to be awkward.
I was a little bit surprised that Order didn't rotate over earlier as well. They sent the Trailblazer down through long from Tux to gather all the information, and then Autumn started to rotate on over. Though Swirl going a bit nuclear in this round, already on for three, looking to lay down the law. He needs to find, though, his counterpart Sky in Tux, and then where Autumn is as well. Bit of a tag to come out through on that Owl Drone, and now he's going to be in for the hunt. Unfortunately, Swirl can't heal himself, but you know that regardless of what HP he's on, he's still going to be sharp for something in the round. Noz finds Autumn, and now it's just on to Tux. Regardless of how this round outcomes, he's going to get those Seekers.
But Autumn looking to reposition again. You know, not a man that shies away from any sort of aggression. Wow. Order walking down mid, and Texter taking matters into his own hands this time around. That's going to be the first time they've actually got an opening pick in the last couple of rounds.
Oh, and a leg onto Swirl as well with that Operator. He can't heal himself as well on the back of that. So Order well in the driver's seat in this round. Though a big reveal onto Texter is going to be to his demise. The rotation now from Tux has to come back over towards this B site. Chop darts on through and all these ultimates coming on out as well. There's the Seekers from Tux. We're looking for a plant here for Wildcard.
All the Seekers destroyed immediately though as well. So no information gathered by Tux. Looking to get that spike planted now, still a 4v4. It's going to be a tough one. They're all rotating in through towards that CP position. Up and close and personal will be Noz. Does have a no more stars actually available either, really, utilizing this position. Onto the other side, using the Cloud Burst to get his way out. This is going to be an all-out brawl here, Dion.
Yeah, and the Hunter's Fury, remember, keep your eyes on that if it's going to be brought on through. There it is as the Showstopper comes on out. It's one-to-one trade in frequent. Finds Disco. That's the rocket down. Tux, meanwhile, looking to get up close and personal in all of these trades. It's just going to be down to infrequent. There's no shock darts available right now as well. You've got the safeguard in Tux to hold down the fort. Three on the entries for this retake, and the defuse is here for Order.
He's back as well. He's going to be able to pepper a little bit tool, a little bit of damage, getting back into the showers as well. Will be Swirl infrequent. Takes a bit of damage. Gather some further info though. Tagged onto the other side of the showers as well. Swirl, his shaky aim. It's so erratic. It looks to make it so much more entertaining. But Autumn, he's going to pick up another one here as well as they swing around the side. Disco going to be the first man to do it. Obviously connecting as well. RDW though, infrequent from the corner. It's all onto RD now. He's got some HP behind him.
So
he's got some positioning, and both of these members are low, but exactly, that's going to be the Overgrowth to come out as well, Dion, and that actually forces him back. Now it's a little bit awkward. Now they can move the unit, tie up, but it's going to be RDW to keep his composure, lining them up, and that will be going to be Order once again, trying to take matters into their own hands, getting all the way in, and while Swell is ready for it, Texter is going to get the advantage here, so they're going to have to pick up the pace over towards this B side right now, Dion. Sign is there waiting, but they got at least plenty of utility to keep him back at elbow for the time being.
Yeah, Sign is going to have to get the call to get his teammates over here to assist as well. You've got that Cosmic Divide available for Noz. I wonder if they want to use that for the post plant or early Seekers. Invested in from Tux right now as RDW pops the poison. He takes out Sign. The player advantage for Wildcard looking to go in toward this post plant right now to the Seekers. They get a little bit of the near side action, and Tux actually picks him through. That's dropping a spike.
Straight into the pit now into a 3-on-3, making a 3-on-2 as Dexter gets one more, but Ninham, he's actually going to be able to find that frag, and now it's a little bit awkward, but RDW, he's on for a 4k here now, Dion, onto the other side, Disco's up close, and now the warning shots are going out for Disco, he's going to be able to equalize here, exactly right, one versus one, RDW, but it is going to be an overstep, and Disco, experience above all.
Maps dropped, we haven't really seen a serious loss from them in a BO3 circumstance in a very long time.
All the time. No wildcard made it such a statement to even be able to find that first one. But once again, it's going to be the Cosmic Divide going down. Sign's going to be caught off guard very, very early. But Ditzko takes matters into his own hands, actually saved up by that Cosmic Divide. But now he's teleported also through and nobody's home. Nobody's home right now. He has no idea. Tucks onto the other side, just waiting patiently. Noz, he's Spike. Actually gone down with his Spike as well, Dion. He was, no! So unfortunate now, looking infrequent, watching, waiting, Ninim just on the other side. They're so split up right now, it's so awkward, infrequent, trying to fire some things, but they're inside! Ninim, how's he found this one right now, Dion?
That's he's just gone through the teleporter. Go through the teleporter, updraft, tailwinds, trying to do something sneaky. Gets the frag, but look at the time right now. Tux, he can do everything he needs. Sure, oh my lord! He might have just won the round in and of itself with that one as well. One versus two, he finds the first. He needs the frag. Autumn just has to hide here. 2-1 on the clock. The nice being brought out. Swell doesn't know. It's been played very well from Order. Oh, but Autumn, it was off the showers. Ditzko is holding back and he gets destroyed.
Oh, Swell, when he's having a game. You know, one of those guys on the come up. Very clean, very crisp. Straight in, the usual that we see from Autumn, looking to take that U-Haul control. Swirl is onto the other side. Has managed to turn away, but plenty of lines coming out from both the Breach and the Sky, but Noz getting his way straight back in. That's going to be Texter going down. Tux good for one, but still alive. We'll be able to get that spike planted down now by Autumn. Tux and Autumn in that position to try and find it, but Swirl brings it all onto just him now. Autumn in a 1v4 and inside the gravity well as well. It's going to be so, so awkward. Hardy!
Oh, no. Yeah, he can't escape from that one.
Bond for just a little while. That shock dart though, Dion. That shock dart's got a lot of damage potential into it. There we go. RDW with the first and frequent with the second and now onto the other side of the toxic screen. Do they even force through this one? How do they approach the rest of the round? But again, well, the toxic just the screen. Eco.
And the poison cloud, sharp shots from Ninim. They're a brick wall at the moment over at the B site. The TP's been heard from Texter, and Noz is just already ready for this. It's good to see that Texter's farmed both of these ultimate orbs, though. He'll get four, charges on it when he loses his life here. So see what he can clear out over at Elbow. But you've just got all of these cross angles for Order that you would expect them to be superior in holding.
So really just trying to find some extra damage, right? You know, you've got the next round where you can go in. Find the full bite. Plenty of good flashes though. This Breach is just so incredibly powerful on a map like this. Ooh. Autumn straight out. Ninim does find it. But it's going to be very, very clean here. Ardy, how does he approach the rest? Only just has the judge. Yep, now Tuck's going to be able to find this easily. And he will. Prime Van.
All the toxins here for RDW at the A site right now. The toxic screen goes up. He's still got the poison cloud as well. Snake bites available when needed. Swell though with the flash comes on.
Was it enough?
Punished though, Texter. He's able to find that one. Tux was able to open up as well. And this round is going absolutely swimmingly for Order. They can invest the seekers if they want to, but I don't think they need to right now. It's just infrequent and Ninim to see what they can gather back.
Don't even know if they're that keen on going for it either, right? This is what we spoke about. Order are just so good at moving in as a unit, confident to check each other's angles for them. But, oh, Ninim, always super dirty on those shots here. Infrequent will be spotted out. We'll be able to get the recon bolt down, though. So really, we can just hope that Ninim finds a couple of things and you don't want to get too much for him. He can always find these frags in this position. And even if he just takes sort of two more weapons, even one more away from the members, it's going to be good damage to be found. But Texter gets the jumping head.
It's going to be Autumn bringing out the blades this time. Infrequent getting out the Hunter's Fury. That's a sharp shot from Ditzko, but RDW, Mitch, he started off onto Ninim. Onto Autumn, rather. That's those blades gone.
Well, both the jets down immediately, right? In a position, Ninim up very, very... Oh, look at this! Spike planted. Right on the line. Swirly, just onto the opposing side of it. Doesn't really mean an inch to collect much, but look at how low Ditzko! Oh, he's trapped right into the corner. 70 points of HP on the other side of the toxins.
I wonder.
It's going to be such a hard defense for Order.
Is RDW going to still clear this angle right now? The toxins have faded on through. There goes the cloud as well. Wildcard, they're taking a lot of time. But Noz has just reamed Ditzko from the site itself. Sign is going to be getting out the aftershock to do something. There's Hunter's Fury as well. Wildcard, lots of investments here. RDW finds Sign down. It's onto Texter. It's onto Tux as well. Tux is down. Texter, looking to showcase here. The defense is coming on through. One through the screen. In toward the classic. And he's getting some damage. But Swirl. Look at this operator, which I believe... It's still going to be silent. Hasn't gotten a shot out with it, and we haven't seen him pick it up on this defensive side just yet.
No, not at all. That's a good shot, though, Autumn. very, very hard to play that offensive-sided operator on a map like Bayern, but now Disco should be able to collect one more, but he's going to be traded. RDW, Mr. Consistent in this game right now. I am so glad to see him up on top. Oh, he's got a third here as well, Dion. This could be a solo hold from RDW.
Oh,
he's lonesome. He's picked up four. Go for the ace, my friend. Not quite. It's not going to matter. Sign in a one versus three, right?
Both of them, I do believe. Yep, they're just elevated on the back of it, and now Sign charging
he's
on three
to clear
the correct angle. There's the
he's
first one.
It.
Now it's on towards Ninim. This could be a massive round from RDW, but brought back by Signed. More time being bought just by that aftershock. Eventually, now he can push on through.
Way.
But there's, remember, Mitch, there's no reconnaissance available for the Ninim right now. He's on the jet.
He's got to try and force his way in. The time is ticking now down to that below 10 seconds, almost onto the defuse, looking to get it to half. Is he just going to stick it though? He's looked off right now, inside the Cloudburst, onto the other side. Sign's giving his position away, but will he be able to hold it? Will he be able to hold it? He will! And that is an incredible... I'm out a couple of times, but now it's going to make it really awkward. The Seekers to go through now as well. Swell needs to connect the shot. He's going to be able to find the first.
Large.
Make that a second as well. Still the one-man army towards this position, but Infrequent is there as well. And now it's all of the tucks inside a one versus... Despite having this position, they don't want to overstay their welcome. And Noz is going to be shouldered out as well. Perfectly poised by order in this position. Swirl looking to make his way around though. Disco just on the opposing side. Swirl needs to make sure he checks this line if he's going to make his way out. But I don't think he will. He actually does in the end. Quick on the reactions from Swirl. He's going to be able to drop one and that makes it a 4-on-4 Dion.
Could see the Seekers be invested here as well to find all the information as the other blades are going to be popped out here by Autumn this time. Do you see Ninim look to clear out the U-hole? There goes in the dart, there goes in the Seekers. He can get some right clicks out here as well with that near side on towards Texas. There's the click. 6 points of HP still to play with. The right click actually misses from Autumn. He gets held W by Infrequent. More trades to keep to see in the round. RDW gets tucked through the boxes and
there
is able to find Sign. RDW.
Infrequent 14 assists. And look, Noz, sure, he's having a quiet one, but it's the Astra, right? The Astra's just all that matters is about the utility. Trying to establish those opening picks, obviously creating the space. And man, Wildcard playing this pins in, but Daninan playing that counter flash, and he's actually going to be able to find the first. What an opening here on the signs.
Very smart as well, playing counter flash as soon as that comes on through. The tendencies of orders showing he's able to find the open, and now it's onto Infrequent with this line. It already damages delivered. There's the first one, Swirl, as well finds Autumn as he tailwinds in toward the site. We are looking at map point. A beautiful flash to come on through. A missed shot from Ninim. Another flash, however, a little bit preemptive. Swirl still. But look at this already, immediately. Wildcard, four players around the site.
Ninim,
same likewise with the Sheriff, starts things off.
They've both got the Jet Sheriff as well, the exact same sign, but it's going to be RDW over up the top. We'll be able to spot out some early information. Signed, looking to swing his ray around. They still haven't really been able to collect a whole lot here.
By the little toxins coming down from both sides at the moment, and actually causes Wildcard to think differently in this round.
Pilski mentioned it, not really sure if the wall onto the other side is the play. It does make it a little awkward if you're not in the right position, but when Ninim's hitting shots like that, it absolutely doesn't matter. Dashing over towards the top, Tux is going to be able to find a dink, but not quite the frag. Onto the other side as well, and Noz going to drop him. It's all an Autumn inside this 1v4, and there's really not a whole lot he can do here. This is about to achieve the impossible. If he does hit the opening shot, he will be able to do so. That's a great bolt as well, underneath the heaven line. Cruising onto the other side now. Is he going to be able to find anything in the...
bonus round. The damage that was seen in the previous one from Order, though, echoing through in the purchase that Wildcard are able to showcase to us in this round. Really just relying on Ninim to see what he can start off on through. The Leer eventually fades, but Ninim gets shut down. Swirl, though, able to find something. And Infrequent, it gets brought back as instantly as it is shut down.
Swirl can pick up a weapon too, but doesn't look like he's actually been able to afford that one right now. The rotate is coming in from Autumn, but it's still that 3v3. They are making their way around. Infrequent's not going to be ready for the swing though. Looks like he's just going to be going for the spike plant. Nice and early, surely. RDW just underneath heaven. Might be able to find some sort of information there, but Swirl is taken low, but he will find a shot. He will be able to dismiss. That's huge to come out from Swirl right now. Looking to reposition around to this other side on the front of the site, but will it be RDW to find Disco? It absolutely will. Now tucks into 1v1. It's going to be RDW. Down for Wildcard.
And it's planted as well, where you can spam it down from the belt position. This little vertical wall to come through, it gives a little bit of an avenue that can be sneaky beaky behind it. Tux, though, finding Noz makes things all the more difficult for Wildcard. 2v4 situation. Remember, this is the lesser weaponry for Order in this round. The blades there on the defuse coming on through as well. The time's ticking away. Tex is just sticking it right now. Have to go out.
Oh my god, Swirl.
He's found through. He's dismissed away. He does get punished in the end. And it's all down to Infrequent, the 1-on-1 trade. Assigned will put a closer to it. Order will get on the board, but man, Swirl, so flashy. He shouldn't have come through from Order, though. Over towards the site. There's the peeking out. There's the opener for Autumn. Absolutely, as you love it. The Resurrection, you'd like to see come through, but it would be at the cost of, you know, the barrier wall as well, or a smoke if they want to try and get that. So with the proceedings in towards the site for Wildcard, this util coming on down, it's going to be a little bit difficult from here.
Clear up. Tux has to sort of fall away. Alarm Bot will be spotted. Nin has plenty of information gathered onto him right now. Swirl will be able to get that one, but he actually goes for the dismiss instead.
Oh, he's fallen.
And he's fallen to his death. That's a little bit awkward.
Autumn still looking to lock down over the Resurrection. And now it's just clean up crew on the mid area from Order. The shot through the smoke, the second one as well. Backing it on up. Ninan will be able to at least gather a tray. But now, look how far split they all are. Disco just wins the duel with the lesser HP. And now it's all going to be onto Infrequent into the holes. He's seen as well, which means the jig is up. And then it's finished. Got his toxic screen available right now, Mitch. He could pop that one up as soon as he gets any inkling that there's something here. There's the first shot. He's not going to be able to escape, unfortunately. If he put up the wall a little bit earlier, he might have been able to do something. But there's the wall. A little bit of a sneaky boost up as well. I absolutely love this. Just methodically in their approach. Wildcard pushing Swell up in toward the holes here with the free plant. They've still got a lot of this utility that they can echo on through. They haven't really used anything in this round.
They
won't know. Now Swell, he's caught them off. He's taken off the head of the Hydra.
He's keen too. This is Swell's playground right now. Going to be dropping out of the kitchen. Disco looking to move on in though. Actually, we'll be able to find that frag. Still a winnable round here for Order right now, but onto the other side. Ninham's going to go up nice and high and also remaining dry. Text up, looking to toy with that res, but does he actually want to go for this one right now? That's going to be into information, but there we go. Text up, sending that one in right now. Tux is going to be back into the server right now, onto the top of the wall though. Ninham will be able to take him down onto the other side. Ninham, that's going to be the other one, and onto the top. He actually flies high, but he will be taken down. Simon, a good trade, but you're exactly right, Dion. There is no time, and that's another one that's going to go the way of Wildcats, but certainly does start to sort of put us into a bit of an awkward situation, but we know how good Autumn is. Holding those versatile lines, but that is going to be the res. How does he look to find this second one? Nice little shot on a Ninham as well. These are the rounds that is basically Autumn's bread and butter right now. He's been allowed free reign of this A site, but Infrequent, he's going to pick up the pace down towards B, dropping down Tux.
Equalization 4-2-4. No one really too far-fetched on the side of Wildcard, except if you look at IDW, he's at least got some control in the tube. They might have had the idea as well. Order, they haven't really got any positionings over here. They need to be clearing out anything. It's going to be a matter of timing, though, and Disco might have found the right timing. But no, actually, IDW somehow finds that. Does he get the next one as well? A pre-fire onto Texta. How has this happened, right?
Very big bit of control looking to be picked up here by Signed. He's in such a pivotal position right now, but he's only got a classic.
And RDW in his tube, it's his hunting ground at the moment. An extra shot to come on through right now. As Sign does get taken on down. There's no way that the spike can be, not going down for Wildcard in this scenario. It's just going to be what damage Order can come out with. And I don't even know if they're going to be able to get anything. But as I say that, cast goes on through. Tux and Order, the blades are pulled out. Okay.
We see this. Seen it before. Ninham did it the only other night. Pop the blades. Able to find plenty. Has to clear this man below him, though. Has they been the warning shots fired? The Tux will be able to clear it. Warning shot to come out from Ninham. Now they can get aggressive. This is where we need one to be on the defusal. No, he's missed the shots, though. And Ninham has somehow managed to find it. Now the Hunter's Fury to come out. Tux needs to be patient, but he also has to pick up. He has to get onto that defuse right now. And now the information. Will he be able to hold long enough? Will he be able to get off of it? He will pull off, but does he have the time?
Nah, he doesn't.
I don't think he does.
Oh, 0.1. Got the Viper's Pit being popped on up by Tux over at the A site. And Autumn has found his second frag in the round. Plant is down. This is a 5-3, better favorable scenario for Autumn now.
And Sign getting those tags up nice and early, but inside the Viper's Pit once more. It's going to be RDW again. He's been so colossal in this map. I wouldn't expect this round to be any different right now. If he stays alive inside that smoke integrity, it's going to make it so, so challenging. But Infrequent, he goes down onto the other side. Now Texter firing a couple of warning shots.
Wow.
It's actually going to be Noz to go and out onto the other side. But now RDW's been spotted. Oh, that was much. RDW in the tube.
He's here again. Is he going to find the frag? Of course
he is.
There's the conversion, the resurrection as well for Wildcard brings them back. And Frequent has managed to sit Autumn down. The leaves have fallen in this round and they are frozen. RDW, though, is hot and heavy under this pressure. 5-2. Lockdown available still here for Tux, who is the last soldier. In 1-5, this is very difficult. He's even popped the lockdown. And oh my lord!
But it's still going to be tough. Ninham, he's taking so low even after this heal. But Swirl, Infrequent, they're on the flank.
Yeah, but look at this gatekeep right now from Order over at this angle. More shots to come on through. They're all really contained over on toward this flank at the moment, and they're winning it down tenfold. Not a single pick to be seen from Wildcard just yet. You've still gotten in him quite low, but they're on the defuse.
No
Canadian
way.
In front of this wall right now, there is. There's a gap, and they're going to exploit it perfectly. Now Infrequent, the last soldier in a 1v5. He is going to have to do... Hey, on this one, good reveal on that owl drone and a very ambitious wall. Texter dead to rights to Infrequent for the first casualty. And that's the spike down too.
Hit him. With a re-entry as well. RDW also there. Up on the top, Autumn trying to fire those warning shots with the Marshall. Tuck's at least good for one. Going to make it a little bit more uncomfortable, a little bit more awkward. They can fall away now. Still 55 seconds left on the clock.
I wouldn't even put it past them.
Nah, it's a possibility always, right? Never count these two out.
Though, it's going to be difficult with a Spectre and a Marshall. They want to find a kill or two and upgrade their weaponry as well in a pretty nice position to find that one. This is away, and now it's just really clinical for Infrequent to finish that one up. That is exactly how you want your first rough. That turret as well. It gets a reveal if anyone's pushing. Disco's going to pop up his head, and he's well rewarded on that patience as well. That is a beautiful turret.
Hardy up close, has more that he has to deal with though. The heal is going to come up, but look how high he is on the other side. Noz is at least going to be able to force them back. The barrier off, the slow orb rather, but that's going to be Noz swinging it around as well.
The white box is just seen. Noz finds that frag, and then he's just bailed out as well. You know, RDW bailed out. Very, very good. And now we move over towards this other site, and it's a bit of chaos for Automitch.
Still an opportunity. Oh, no, swirl here with a bad bit of timing. That's going to be Disco to find it. Now the turret
left.
Can go down. The spike will be planted here. Both these members are close up, near on towards the site. RDW with the right bit of timing. He could be able to find sign here. I don't think they're actually going to be ready, but he tucks into the corner just at the appropriate time. He needs to get moving quickly, though. There's the spot. There's the information. It's all on the Disco now. Certainly a man that we've seen win these kind of rounds. Formerly on the Raze. Will it now be another Killjoy? The answer is no. Wildcard on top. They've stacked this deck, Theon, 11 rounds now. As Order, their economy is busted.
Yeah, it's looking like Order are the jokers in that.
Does he actually want to try find something inside the pit? Or is he going to fall away? It's going to be awkward regardless. He's actually going to be the sole detainee in this position. Autumn's going to be able to drop Infrequent in the process as well, but they're not keen. They don't want to overextend here yet, Theon. Mm. It's going to be Ninim to actually find Disco on the flank. RDW, though, still alive inside this pit somehow, some way.
He really wants HP, but look at this position from Ninim. He's just gatekept the spike. He's gatekept the raise when Disco is brought on back. He's able to get out the gun, though. Mention he might be able to convert this frag as well. He does. It's a 4v2 favorable scenario right now for Order, and they need to be able to find this one as well. Swell, he's looking for something. Falls on back. He's still got these leers and these charges as well to devour or dismiss away. Probably the latter where we know how Swirl likes to play it. But it's on to him and Noz to bring this one back.
All going to go down. The second this screen fades, there might be an opportunity. There it is. That's going to be the spike drop.
5 seconds.
There's no time. There's not anything available, but it's actually going to be touched to be able to find it. No! Noz couldn't get deep enough. There was... Swirl, what have you got? Both the wall sides will be destroyed, and that's the spike as well. And now he's kind of caught in the crossfire a little bit here. Hunter's Fury has actually tagged him up, but Ninim on the top of the boiler. We'll be able to find a second frag back into it now. 3-on-5, Dion. That's completely slowed the pace, and look how far the spike is away from the remaining members of Order.
Always, you know, kind of expect a bit of a change of pace after a pause as well. You know, do you go with haste or do you slow it down? Wildcard, they have gone with a little bit of haste into all this round. A quick flank to be seen as well from RDW as Order. They finally got the one frag into all this board. Here's that flank, courtesy of Crash Cam coming on the back of it. I'm not going to be expecting this one. The reload, they're kind of locked in. The turret as well. I don't think it's going to be revealing them. No, it is. Now they know the flank's there. The toxins to go on through as well. And the res comes on out. This is everything for Wildcard. Free fire's bound. They know exactly where Disco is. The resurrection.
Probably a little bit quieter than the rest of them, but
yeah.
You know, it's just great group of guys. All bringing it together. Different backgrounds across the board. You know, what do we got? A little bit of Overwatch, I guess. Swell technically doesn't even have a background, you know, played CSGO once upon a time.
Yes, yes.
Infrequent CS. Where did RD... Exactly, and that spike will be planted. Very open for everything. All the chaos is about to ensue, Dion. This is the time. This is the opportunity. Sign is waiting for RDW, knowing that that flank is there, but he's gone deep. He's gone around to the other side. Will he actually be ready for it? Will he swing? He gets the info, and RDW continues to be the man in the backpack, into the backpack. pocket. Goes to find one more.
There it is.
Swirl, and that is the round done. RDW, take a bow, my friend, because you have just...
This is technically Order's map pick coming through in this best of five. It was 2 for Wildcard, 2 for Order. Then you got the remainder. But look at that, man. Off the get-go, the smoke blossoms and infrequent. He blooms.
The paint shells were there to back him up as well in the off chance that he was potentially going in scathed, but now it's going to be that rotate. The site is going to be taken. Order have to fight from behind. Spike will go down on the site. Disco up inside heaven in a good position to deny. Ninham's going to go running in though, and the B-hop's his best boon impression, and Sign trying to walk on in. RDW, patient as ever. And is that a flawless on this map, Theon? You've just got this bloody jet swinging around with a classic right-click at you and just digging you down to 8 HP. Like, just, how do you deal with that?
I don't think you do. But at least Tux is going to be starting things off. Now Ninim's found Disco as well for a trade. A little bit of damage already. If Swirl finds the timing right, he might be able to find something to stop the stampede over at this A site. There goes the satchel as well. Sees Tux. Wants to play carefully though. Wait for his team to come over. Because you've still got 4 players for both sides right now. Order, they have to plant this objective.
Yeah, they've got to go.
They're getting denied a little bit at the moment.
Tux
is going to get peppered down.
Oh, my! Oh, what? 2 HP, Autumn. If he does not play his cards right, we're going to be seeing a full house for Wildcard right now. One pulled into the gravity well as well. Swirl one on the flank, and now it's all on the Texter. How has this happened, Dion? I mean, there's a world where he wins this. There's one, but he's going to find so many more, and how?
From Noz. The paint shells, though, for the time being. Swirl contemplating the right time as he's going to jump over the RDW's trap wire. RDW down, and now Swirl. There's the first one. The paint shells as well. Decently lobbed in free kick. There's two to come on through. The gravity well in combination is brilliant. And now it's just down to the last soldier in the mail room and sign.
Disco is a lot push on in as well. At least the showstopper's available though.
Yeah, a lot for infrequent to do right now. He's stuck over at the default box as well, and I think Disco's going to be able to find him.
The rocket eventually,
he gets his head taken off. Another one. Nope, it's not going to come into play. Still this player advantage for Wildcard as it's equalized. Noz looking to do something dire right now. 2v2. Enough time to get back down. But look at the flank coming through from RDW. I wonder.
Oh, Jesus. They've got to be, though, right? You know, the amount of times he did it into Icebox on that Viper, and Autumn is absolutely ready for this right now, holding that line. But RDW, are you kidding me, my friend? All on a sign, back at the site, up in towards heaven. Ninham's going to be able to spot him out. And RDW, again, he's just been so good, so sharp. That Nebula's about to fade, but he's not even going to need it. Putting that one down now. They are yet to pick up this pace though, Dion. They don't want to go in. RDW is actually going to be able to find the opener. The lockdown is not far back enough, and that's going to be infrequent to find another. They've used absolutely everything, but RDW, he's just a troll with this camera. He's forcing them back. It's making it awkward. Sign has to go for some form of engagement. It doesn't even matter, Dion. The man can just sit there holding fast, finding not quite the frag, but it's one HP, and so it is. That is just such a predicament. I don't even care, dude. It's just, hopefully I jinx it so we get a fourth map, right?
Yeah, look, you're not wrong. We want to see Order be able to bring something back in this, as they are number one team in the region at the moment. They've gotten the first opening pick in this round as well. RDW to spray through the Nebula as he's able to dispatch a boredom. Look at his camera as well. Any information that he can get pinged off that would have been brilliant, but he's going to get shut down. And now Swirl with a showstopper finds Tux. 3-on-3.
There's one. Disco holding from the heavens, though. He's going to be able to find his third in the round. And this is Disco's time to go big. He already has, but you're exactly right, Dion. Infrequent can go for that one, even if he chooses to just bait it out. But Disco, go for the ace, my friend. This could be the 6K, but no, it's denied. It's turned on its head, and all of a sudden, the first opportunity. Disco did so much, but it's just still... Tux might be able to find the timing here. That's a good opportunity. Huge. Maybe we see them come back. Spike in the hands, of course, of Texter. This is the dynamic duo, Dion. Tux, Texter. We saw them play under the banner of the Chiefs for so, so long in CSGO. Mm-hmm. Doing worlds of work. They move over to Valorant. Another opportunity. And their time is now. Can they bring this back? Tux looking to reposition. To try and take some control, but he's going to be denied.
An operator.
Texter has to do a what? Operator 1v3.
Yeah, it's not the gun that you want in a situation like this. I was going to say in the 3v2, do you see the Cosmic Divide come on through? You don't. There was a right click from Texter on towards Infrequent.
Nebula's going to be able to go down, but yeah, it's a little awkward. Might have to even go for the Bladestorm in this position here. Dion potentially finding the moment where we might actually see Order get around on the board. But RDW, he's in pole position. One, two, the lockdown. Who? What a lockdown. No there anymore. And on to the other side. RDW, he's picked up the operator. Are you kidding me right now? Go for four, my friend. It's not quite enough. But it's all on to Just Swirl. One versus two. But Order, see you later, mate. You're going to be going down here. The satchel to send him to the side. He has to go quick. He has to go somewhere far. But how does Swirl approach this? Disco, he does have it. That's the fake drop as well. Swirl into the head of Disco right now. Is he going to be able to find the timing? And do you know what? Wildcard. When RDW's feeling it, RDW's feeling it. And Frequent does get the leg shot off. And Swirl takes him down. Oh, geez. And I think it's like, you can just see the mental of Order right now. I'm not even going to say they've given up. It's just like they must be so quiet and frustrated right now, which it's just not a thing that happens for Order basically ever. And RDW, he's going to find this on the sign in the spawn. Yeah, he's not even safe in his own spawn, Dion.
And Infrequence just found Tech, so that means the Resurrection's down if you wanted to go for it. Yeah, you've lost a little bit of control from Order. Now you know where they are exactly with the destruction of that trap wire. Ninim with the op is just going to find the frag. This is a flawless nature. Maybe round. There it is, Swirl. Closes it. I don't know what has happened. Bit of vulnerable on a Ninim to start things off. Looking for the opening pick. And he's even going to find it. The res can probably come on through, but you've got the Texter player over here. There, you've got an Odin from Infrequent. They get pulled into the Gravity Well. It's a 1-on-1 trade. Texter needs to be very careful. He gets taken down from the Showstopper. This is destruction in the last round of this half. And yeah, the last round in this half, ladies and gentlemen. The Neural Theft could even come out if RDW can, but he's over at A at the moment where Tux is creeping on through. Ooh. Good patience from Disco, though, to be able to find Swirl. And as Tux falls back,
the spike, though, look where it is.
Yeah, exactly.
How do you even approach this? Ninim holding that line. Does only have... Oh, he's got a couple. Three blades available. Onto the other side. Just sitting, waiting. Why wouldn't ya at this point? Mm-hmm. RDW clearing out all of A, gathers the information. Turret's actually not going to be spotting out anyone here. Does go for a little warning shot. Now can gather. And again, Tux, you know... I guess the big play is Disco. He's already gone into CT here. Noz still checking, still clearing, making sure that he is aware of the prospect. Look at that. Tux, my friend, do you have it in you in this 1v3?
Well, the peeking on through has been tagged, he's been known. There's the first one. You've still got that Neural Theft and Cosmic Divide as well. He's got to get the spike. There's definitely a winning strategy here for him if he can find these disconnected jewels. He's not going to be able to upgrade it. Sorry?
Does Noz have a camp here? I just saw him go in. I think
RDW
he does.
With the camera. Ooh.
No, sorry, I meant RDW, but it doesn't matter.
Tux can win this.
Two bullets. Ooh. Is it the dream?
He needs a ding. There it is.
No.
It's a flawless half. If you are Tux, what do you ask for in this? Do you get out your rifles? You're going to have to get some sort of upgrade to go toe-to-toe against the big guns on the wild card side. And we're seeing Tux to drop over the Spectre. So he can get up a Phantom. We're seeing a Judge to come through from Swirl in towards mid if they could go for the exploration. But with the stars starting to go down onto the A site, two smokes or nebulas are popped. A Gravity Well to the back of the site as well. And there's the sending in from Swirl that I was expecting with the Judge. He does find a snap on toward Disco. Now the shot's from Sign. He needs more than one. He has his teammate out for the trades. The trades, they need to come through. There's only Tux now available to do something sinister. 1v3, Mitch. Is this it?
Tux. It's all on you, my friend. The pressure is nigh. The camera spotted you. But it'll be all eyes on you if you're able to find...